don't know.
Let your mama out of it, honey.
Against judging, and
no,
you are judging.
Jesus wasn't. And you don't
yes,
read your
he
Bible,
was. He was accepting
and you don't read your Bible,
everybody.
And he's not again. I can show you.
What about the man that bombed?
I can show you.
Yes. He forgave the man next to
God.
God.
He forgave
why
everybody
for
himself
their sin if he was
yeah.
against judgment. Why did
God's
he stand himself against
sinners?
Sin.
God
will kill
okay. But it's not your
God.
Job to be God.
God.
It is
my
not
job
your job to
tell
be
you
God.
The truth. Your job is to make
no.
a decision. God
no.
hates all works of iniquity. God will destroy those who speak falsehood, speak lies. God will punish the world for its loves and the wicked for their
evil. And
God
evil?
Does not love.
Hatred is a form of evil.
God's
and you are hating
love.
People who are different.
We all feel so
hurt
by coffee, but
which is a
God
sin.
God
and
will
all I have to say to you, sir, is
well,
that you are a sinner
good,
and you realize
I mean,
you are one too. It's not just
well,
people who are different.
I was a sinner.
That's all I have to say.
I deserve hell, but God saved me. So now because of what Jesus done, I've been changed. I have a new nature. He doesn't say, he says, judge with righteous judgment. Don't put words in God's mouth. You'll be found a liar.
Why would he put someone in hell if they know
God?
You are sitting here and telling everybody what the Bible says.
I'm telling you how to
be
saved.
You are interpreting the Bible. No, you can't tell. Hold on, hold on. I have
we're telling you how to be saved.
Okay.
Wait, let her talk, please.
One person
okay,
let's do this.
I have something to say. Like, I completely respect everybody's views, but, like, until, like, you cannot, your father, your Lord, does not want you to tell people that they're going to go to hell because they don't believe it.
We
would
like to tell
them,
God.
No,
you're
but
not God,
God,
either.
God doesn't judge
so
people, so you do
God's
not
God.
Tell
listen,
people
God
that they're going to go to hell.
God kills people.
Because
God
you don't want to tell
you're
not
God.
God.
Not God.
God kills people.
We're
just,
moving
around.
No,
okay,
guys.
So are you going to die someday or no?
No, the police officer.
Do you know when?
But the
no,
thing
no, no.
Okay, so why do you die?
You can't tell people
sin
that
kills.
They're going to go to hell and that they need Jesus.
No,
because
no.
they don't believe
you
what
need to be
you
saved.
Believe.
No, no, your
yeah,
body kills
you.
We're telling you how to be saved from the wrath of God that abides upon you right now.
You're
just
still
oh, oh, we have
to
do
it.
But the thing is, there's way for people to engage in you in a positive way. And then there's ways that you can alienate people and actually have them close the door
to
the
Well, they're still standing here. That's Glenn talking. So, ma'am, your ways.
You're talking.
If you, hey, dude, if you want
to
do that, go do that.
Go
preach the gospel.
I'm just
trying
to help
you.
And
you're
trying
to
help
anybody.
I'm
trying to
get you to connect with people.
Okay.
No,
but you're
obviously doing it right.
And that's
I'm just
not,
telling, I'm telling you the truth.
That is not how Jesus
talks. Honestly, he's preventing the girl from doing her own homework and learning the education of whatever she's doing.
Jesus came to bring a sword. Division.
Hey,
Christ
nice
brings division because people don't want God and they hated Christ. They destroyed him on the cross. His own people killed him. God took his own son and killed him and destroyed him for crimes he didn't commit so that people would be able to be forgiven. The problem is because God is pure and holy and we're not. We're separated from God. And in God's sight, we're all criminals. We're liars. We're covetous. We're greedy. We're arrogant.
We're
prideful. Human nature is evil. And God is evil.
God's message and not that
you need
to
be saved.
Exactly.
You need to be saved from God. Because God is the judge of the earth, and God will judge the world.
Okay,
without Christ, God will destroy you.
Okay, guys, I just want you to be quiet for a second. All right. I'm going to ask you, all right, how many of you believe there's a higher power? Okay, do you believe that a higher power would have to be a just God? Somebody that if he's going to judge you and make a rule or something, that he would have to live by those rules. Okay, so the Old Testament said, you have the Ten Commandments and this is it. Okay, well, God in the New Covenant through Jesus said, everybody is a sinner. No, nobody lived this earth without being a sinner, except Jesus. Okay, so I'm going to ask you a few questions, and I want you to be honest with the answers, okay?
All right.
How many of you have lied?
No.
How many of you have ever stolen anything, even if it's small, and you didn't do it on purpose?
Please, yeah.
Anybody ever use the Lord's name in vain?
Oh, yeah. God.
Okay. The Bible says, if you even look at a woman or man in lust,
that's right.
You have then committed adultery.
That's right.
Has any of you ever looked at a boy or girl and lusted?
Have you seen them, buddy?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
I love girls.
Okay.
About,
right? So what you've told me is you are lying, thieving, blasphemous, adulterers at heart, and now you are facing God on Judgment Day.
Okay. Absolutely.
Are you going to be innocent or are you going to be guilty?
I'm going to hell.
No. That's not
what you want.
Innocent?
I don't care.
Guys, let her talk, please.
Innocent or guilty?
Innocent.
Guilty.
Okay.
Guilty.
So now what if there was somebody in the room who said that they would pay your fine for you?
I'd give
would
them
you
a
would,
hit.
Right? Okay.
I would.
So what Jesus